Wet your hands with water. Apply soap, rub your hands palm to palm, and wash the backs of both hands and in between your fingers. Then palm to palm with fingers interlocked. Clasp your hands together and rub. And then clean around the thumbs too. Rub your fingertips in the palms of your hands and finish off with the wrists. Rinse your hands really well with water and dry them thoroughly with a paper towel. Use the towel to turn off the tap. Your hands are now clean.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of Allah, who is the most merciful and most gracious. Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. How are you all? Hopefully, you all will be fine. Well, first of all, I would like to say welcome you all in my social studies class of grade 2. This is week number 9 and lecture number 1. As you know my name is Mrs. Sadaf Amreen. General instructions. Before going to start, there are some general instructions, so listen carefully, okay? So, my dear students, first of all, you have to mark your attendance. And secondly, keep ready your book, notebook, pencil, eraser and sharpener to note down the answers of the questions. And if you have any questions, you can ask in the WhatsApp group. Hope the instructions are clear to follow. Contents. What we are going to study in this lecture. Look at here. Lesson number 13. Animals around us. This lesson we have studied already. In our previous lecture we have done reading and explanation of this lesson. So first of all I will give you a preview what we have studied in this lesson. And after that then we will write question number 5 on copy. And page number 64, exercise A on book, we will do this exercise. And there is an activity that you have to do it at your home. That is, draw or paste a picture of your favorite animal on copy. Okay? So, these things we will study today. Okay? So, get ready for that. Lesson number 13. And what is the name of the lesson? Lesson name is Animals Around Us. Okay, so today we will study more about animals around us. Okay, so get ready for that preview. So first of all, I will tell you about what we have studied in the lesson. Okay, so listen carefully. Look at here, my dear students. These are wild animals. You know, there are two kinds of animals as we have studied in this lesson. Wild animals and domestic animals. Here, you will see the pictures of wild animals. Okay, so look at here. Here is a picture of lion, chimpanzee, monkey, tiger, giraffe, hippo, crocodile, polar bear and zebra. These are all wild animals. These are not friendly animals. These are very dangerous animals. So that they can't live with us and they'll live very far away from us. And where they live? They live in the forest. Okay? We cannot keep them in our homes because they are very dangerous. That's why they live in the forest. Look at here in this picture, you can see tiger, lion, okay? And you can see here a crocodile, okay? Here is a tiger, and you know where tiger is live? Tiger lives in the forest. Why? Because it is a wild animal. It is a dangerous animal. And crocodile is also a very dangerous animal and it lives in the rivers. So these animals are wild animals, okay? And they live very far away from us because they are very dangerous. So where they live? Wild animals live in the forest and some wild animals live in the rivers like crocodile. Domestic animals. As I told you before that there are two kinds of animals, wild animals and domestic animals. Now here are some pictures of domestic animals. Look at the pictures. Dog, cat, cow, parrot, horse, goat. These are all domestic animals. These animals are friendly animals. We can keep them in our homes. They can live with us and we can get many benefits from them. Like we can get food from them and some animals we can use as a transport also, like horse. Okay, so these are domestic animals. They are also called tame animals because they can live with us. They are friendly. They are very useful for us. Like dog. Dog is very faithful animal, you know. And we can keep him in our house for our safety as well. Okay. Now here is a cat. Cat is also very beautiful and cute animal. And here is a cow. Cow is very beneficial for us. We can get milk from cow and meat also. Similarly, we can get milk and meat from goat. And parrot is also very beautiful bird. We can keep them parrots in our home. They are very lovely. They speak up also sometime if they are trained. And horse is very useful animal. We can ride on horse. We can move from one place to another. So we can use it as a transport also. Okay. So these are all very friendly animals. That's why these are domestic animals. And we can get lots of benefits from them. Allah has created these animals for human benefits. Okay, so these are very useful animals. They can live with us and they can live on farms also. Okay, so look at the picture here. As I told you that they can live in our homes. Yes, they are friendly animals. They can live in our homes and they can live on farms. They can live on farms. Especially chickens are reared on poultry farms and we can get eggs and meat from chicken. So these are all domestic animals and farm animals also. Okay, because they can live on farms and they can live in our homes. You can see here different pictures of animals like hen, cow, sheep, and elephant, horse, pony, or donkey. So what we can get from hen? We can get eggs from hens. And milking a cow, we can get milk from cow. We can also get meat from cow. And we can get wool from sheep. Yes, we can get wool from sheep that we can use to make our different kinds of clothes. We can get milk and meat and leather from buffaloes, cows and goats. Okay, so these animals are very useful animals and we can keep them in our homes. That's why they are called tame animals or domestic animals. Now look at down, elephant, pony, donkey. These are also very useful animals. And horse, ponies, camels and bulls pull carts and wagons, so we can use them as a transport. And you can also see donkey here. Donkeys, camels and horses carry load. As you can see in the picture, donkey carries a heavy load. And you know, elephant is a very big animal and it can move the heavy logs. So all animals are the creatures of Allah, or you can say these are living things. As we are human beings, we are living things, and similarly animals are also living things. You know, plants are also living things. So as we can feel pain and happiness and sadness, so similarly as they are living things, animals are living things. That's why they can also feel pain and sadness and happiness, everything. So if we will hurt them, they can feel also. Although they can't speak, but they can feel in their own way. So what we should do? We should take care of them. Okay, we shouldn't hurt them. We must be very kind to the animals. We should take care. How we can give them a good care? By keeping them clean, by providing them healthy food, okay, and by providing them pure water also. We should keep their places clean also, okay, where they live. So we should take care of the animals, because animals are living creatures. Okay, Allah ki jo hai ye ek makhluk jisko hum animals kehte hain, they are living things. So we should take care of them. Okay, as we are living things, similarly animals are also living things. Okay, so we should be very kind to animals. So this is the preview that we have studied already in our previous lecture, in the previous lecture, in this lesson. So now what's the new today's work? So look, let's see about the today's work. Today's work, what we will do new today in this lecture. Get ready for that. Lesson number 13, animals around us. Question number 5. Dear students, you have to note down the answer of question number 5 on your notebook. Okay, so what is the question number 5? Why should we be kind to animals? Hame animals ke saath kyun kind hona chahiye? Okay, so the answer is, we should be kind to animals because they are living creatures and very useful for us. Okay, you know, these are animals are living creatures. You know, as we are living things or we are living creatures, similarly animals are also living creatures of Allah. So they can feel and they can but they cannot speak, but they can feel everything. Okay, if you hurt them, they can feel pain. So we should be kind to animals because they are living creatures and they are also very useful for us. We can get different benefits from the animals, like we can get food in terms of milk and meat and eggs, and we can also get some kind of transport facility from the animals, like horse providing us, like camel providing us some type of transport. We can also move from one place to another by using them, and we can also use them to carry the heavy loads. So these are the animals are very useful creature of Allah. So we should be kind to animals. So the answer that is we should be kind to animals because they are living creatures and very useful for us. Okay, my dear students, you have to note down this answer on your notebook. Okay, so the same thing that you have to follow, you should draw the margin line, write down the CW, date, topic, and then you will write the question number 5 and the answer of question number 5. Okay, so what is the question number 5? Why should we be kind to animals? Answer is we should be kind to animals because they are living creatures and very useful for us. Okay. Lesson number 13, animals around us. Work page, exercise A, page number 64. Okay, what you have to do it on this exercise, you have to unscramble the names of these animals. Okay, here are the names of animals, but their names are not written in their correct spelling. So unscramble, jumble letters are there of the names of the animals. Okay, like very first anthelpe, that that is the actually the spelling of elephants. So we need to write spelling of elephant in a correct way. So these are jumbled letters of the names of the animals. We have to unscramble them, okay, and write them in a correct way. Like the first one is elephant, E-L-E-P-H-A-N-T. So this work there, you have to do it on your book. Where you can find the place, you can write the correct spelling of the name of the animal. Like if you find the place over here, you can write it here. But if the place is not sufficient, you can write at the downside of the of here, okay, of the name of the elephant. Okay, so you have to do this work on your book. The first is elephant. Number 2, spinoe, is ponies. So you have to write ponies, p-o-n-i-e-s, ponies. The third one is camel, m-a-c-e-l, actually it is camel. So C-A-M-E-L, camel. The fourth one is S-O-R-E-H. What is this? It is horse. So the spelling of horse is H-O-R-S-E, horse. Number 5, C-L-O-K-L-U-B. What is this? This is bulk, B-U-L-L-O-C-K, bulk. Then number 5, Y-O-N-D-E-K. This is donkey. So number 5 is donkey, D-O-N-K-E-Y, donkey. So in this way, you have to unscramble the names of the animals and rewrite in a correct way. Okay, inko dubara se aapne inke spelling correct karke inke name likhne hain. Theek hai, aapko jahan par proper स्पेस मिले, लाइक वर्ड के ऊपर मिले या नीचे मिले, आपने वहां पर इसको लिख देना है. ठीक है, दिस वर्क यू हैव टू डू इट ऑन योर बुक. अंडरस्टैंड? सो एलिफेंट, पोनीज, कैमल, हॉर्स, बुल्क एंड डोंकी. ओके, सो यू हैव टू डू दिस वर्क ऑन द बुक. अंडरस्टैंड? ओके. Home task. Lesson number 13, animals around us. We have studied this lesson and we have also done question number 5 on copy in this lecture. So page number 64, exercise A on book. Okay, dear students, you have to complete this work and there is an activity, draw or paste a picture of your favorite animal on copy. So these three things you have to do it as a home task. Okay. So your writing must be very neat when you will write on book or on the copy. And you should do your work in a very beautiful handwriting. Okay, dear students, this is all about from my side. And if you have any question, as I told you before, that you can ask me through WhatsApp group. And okay, dear students, thank you for listening me, for watching this lecture also. Take care. Allah Hafiz. Have a nice day.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Welcome in Islamiyat class. How are you, dear students? I hope you are fine and happy. As you know, it is our Islamiyat period. I am Mrs. Amara Zubair. First, I want to tell you about the contents. Today, we will read the unit number 13, Our Guest, page number 15 and 16. Unit number 13, Our Guests. Today our topic is Our Guests. Guests are a blessing from Allah. They bring happiness and love to our home. Our dear Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam said, anyone who believes in Allah and the last day should honor his guest. You should treat your guests with love and respect. Welcome your guests with a smile. Offer them a good place to sit and try to make them comfortable. You should offer them something good to eat or drink. Serve them yourselves instead of asking a servant to do it. Do not say or do anything to insult your guests or mistake them. Feel unhappy when your guests leave. Accompany them to the door. Our dear Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam offered his guests the best of whatever he had. Sometimes he even went hungry but offered them food. Once a guest came from very far to meet the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam in Medina. The traveler was tired and hungry. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam asked someone to bring the milk from his home. After enjoying the milk, the guest thanked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. That night, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam slept hungry because that milk was all he had in the house. Sometimes you may have fruits or fruit juices. Chocolates are a favorite food in the fridge at home. Do you offer these to your guests? What do you think the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam would have done? नो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आप सबको इस लेसन में समझ आई है ना कि इसमें क्या है कि हमें क्या बताया गया है कि हमें अपने गेस्ट की रिस्पेक्ट करनी चाहिए. हमारे प्यारे नबी हजरत मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम ने हमें यही सिखाया है कि जब हमारे घर में कोई भी गेस्ट आए तो हमें उनकी रिस्पेक्ट करनी चाहिए, उन्हें अच्छी जगह पर बिठाना चाहिए. जो हमारे पास सबसे अच्छा खाना हो वो उन्हें ऑफर करनी चाहिए, अच्छी जगह पे बिठानी चाहिए और उनके सामने कोई ऐसी बात नहीं करनी चाहिए जिससे वो ना खुश हो. ठीक है, अगर हमारे पास जैसे आपके पास कोई चॉकलेट है, कोई फ्रिज में अच्छा जूस है, कुछ भी है, तो आपको चाहिए अपने गेस्ट को वो सर्व करे, बजाय इसके कि आप किसी दूसरे से कहें, किसी सर्वेंट से कहें, बल्कि कोशिश करनी चाहिए कि अपने गेस्ट की खुद रिस्पेक्ट करें, खुद उसकी उसको खाने पीने की चीजें ऑफर करें. ठीक है कि हमारे प्यारे नबी सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम ने हमें यही सिखाया कि हम अपने मेहमानों की रिस्पेक्ट करें, उनकी इज्जत करें. और इस कहानी में एक वाक्या भी बताया गया है कि एक दफा का जिक्र था कि हमारे प्यारे नबी सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम से एक आदमी बहुत दूर से मिलने आया हुआ था. तो प्यारे नबी सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम ने किसी को भेजकर अपने घर से दूध मंगवाया और वो अपने मेहमान को पिला दिया. तो मेहमान ने दूध पीकर उनका बहुत शुक्रिया अदा किया. तो प्यारे नबी उस रात भूखे सोए थे क्योंकि उनके घर में सिर्फ वही दूध था जो उन्होंने अपने मेहमान को पिला दिया था. तो इस सबक से हमें यही, इससे लेसन से हमें यही सबक मिलता है कि हमें अपने मेहमानों की, अपने गेस्ट की इज्जत करनी चाहिए, उनको बेहतरीन खाना सर्व करना चाहिए. और अगर हमारी फ्रिज में कोई अच्छी चीज है, अच्छा खाना है, चॉकलेट्स हैं, तो उन्हें वो भी ऑफर करनी चाहिए. आप सब ऐसा करते हैं? आप सब बहुत अच्छे बच्चे हैं, आप अपने फ्रेंड्स के साथ चीजें भी शेयर करते होंगे और अब इस लेसन को पढ़ने के बाद अगर आप नहीं भी करते तो बेटा आप सब अपने गेस्ट को अपनी जो बेहतरीन चीज होगी वो जरूर ऑफर करेंगे, ठीक है बेटा? नो इट इज द टाइम ऑफ होम असाइनमेंट. तो डियर स्टूडेंट्स यू रीड दिस लेसन एट लीस्ट टू टाइम, ओके? इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन यू कैन आस्क योर टीचर ऑन व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप, ओके बेटे? थैंक यू फॉर लिसनिंग मी, ओके, टेक केयर, अल्लाह हाफिज, फी अमानिल्ला.
Assalamu alaikum and good morning everyone. I welcome you in computer science class. And how are you my dear students? Hope all of you are fit, fine and happy. So, it's now time for your computer science class. Today we are gonna start lecture 1 of week number 9 and I am your computer teacher Miss Zermina. So now let's get started. As you know that we are going to continue with chapter 8, that is, what is the name of chapter? Formatting in WordPad. So, my dear students, open your computer science books, page number 40. Quickly open your book, page number 40. As today we are gonna cover the last topic of this chapter, that is, formatting in WordPad. Open your book quickly, then here are the contents, okay? First of all, we will revise our previous topic. Then we are gonna start our new topic, that is paragraph group buttons. We are going to learn about the paragraph group buttons and you will have a practical activity after the explanation of this topic. So get ready. Our today's objective is that at the end of the lesson, you will be successfully able to apply the formatting to a document. Like we have done previously about some other formatting tools and buttons that were in the font group. And today we are going to continue formatting from the font group and also from paragraph group buttons. Okay, so let's start with the recalling our previous topic. In our previous lecture, we studied about the font group buttons. So what is formatting? Formatting text. What is the meaning of formatting text? Yes, formatting text means to make your text look beautiful by giving it different color. You could changing the size of the font, changing the font family, and even by highlight, like highlight the text. So, formatting text means to make it beautiful by using different font group buttons. For example, font family, font size, text color, text highlight color. All of these buttons, like in order to make your text look beautiful, the first group which you are gonna use is the font group, okay? And there are so many buttons by which you can make your text look beautiful. And where is the font group button? It is in the home tab. So whenever you open WordPad, the active tab, that is home tab, and home tab has so many groups, and each group contain different buttons, and with the help of these button you can format or arrange your text in the document. So this was about the font group button. You can even bold your text with the help of bold button and make your text look slanting or sideways with the help of which button? Italics. If you want to make the text look slanting or sideways, which button you're gonna use? Italics. And if you want to underline the text, which button you are going to use? That is underline. The symbols are like this. Bold is for B, is for bold. Here you can see slanting I, it's for italics, and U, and there is line under it, that is underline. So these are some tools or the buttons in the font group. Like with the help of these, you can also make your text look beautiful. Or in other words, what we can say, you, with the help of these buttons, you can format your text in WordPad. So today we are going to learn about how to bold and italics and underline. This will be also in your practical activity, okay? Now moving on to the next one, that is font group. Okay, now let's revise the names of each button in the font group. We will start with the font family. This is the font family, and here is the drop down arrow. When you click on it, you can see a number of different font styles. So we call it font family. Then font size. If you want to increase or decrease the size of your text, you are going to press this drop down arrow and select the size of your choice. Then bold. This is for bold. If you want to make your text look thicker or darker, you are gonna press this button, that is bold. After bold, italics. You know that for italics, if you want to make your text look italics or slanting or sideways, you are going to press this I. So the name of this button is italics. And if you underline, if you want to underline the text, which button you are going to press? This U. Here you can see U, and there is line under it, so its name is underline. So you are going to press this button. After selecting the text, you are going to press this button. Then text highlight color. If you want to make your text highlight it, then you are gonna use this highlight text highlight color. And the next one is text color. If you want to change the color of your text, you are gonna use this button. So the name of this button is text color. Okay, these are some names of font group buttons. Hope all of you memorize them, and as we have revised them so many times. So now let's move on to today's topic. Our today's topic is about paragraph group buttons. Okay, this is the icon or the paragraph group button. These are different icons like buttons in the paragraph group. So This paragraph group buttons allow you to align your text, okay? This button or this groups allow you for the alignment, okay? So there are four alignment, and even the line spacing, and if you want to give like make the list, then you can also add bullet points with the help of this group, okay? In this group, so we will start with the four alignment buttons in this group. As we already studied about them, the alignment, so we will start with the word alignment. You have to pronounce the word alignment, okay? Alignment. So alignment means to arrange the text on the left side, right side, center of the document, okay? What is the meaning of alignment? It means, like you can see right now, the text is aligned on the left side of the screen, as you can see over here, right? This is alignment, like arrange or move your text on the right, left side of the screen, right side of the screen, or in the center of the screen. Like if you want to make your text or in the document, you make it in the document, align it on the left side or right side, you are going to use these paragraph group buttons. So basically there are four major alignment buttons in this group, in paragraph group, which is the name of this group, paragraph group, okay? The name of this group is paragraph group. So the main four alignment buttons are align left. What is it? Align left. It means if you want to arrange your text on the left side of the screen, left side of the screen, you are going to select the text and just press this button. Then the next is center. Now, if you want to make your text in the document in the center of the document, you are going to press this button, that is center. Okay, now the third button is about align text right. Align text right, as the name shows, right. So it means if you want to arrange your text on the right side of the screen of the document, then you are going to press this button, and the name of this button is align text right. Okay, and the fourth one is justify. Like this is the fourth one, and it says it's justify. Justify means that to arrange your text like on the both side, there must be equal, both sides must be equal. So to take a text on both left and right sides, their sides must be equal from both right side and the left side must be equal. So I'm gonna show you how you're going to justify align text right, center, and align text left in the document, okay? I'm going to show you this also. So there are some other buttons, that is line spacing. So these are four major alignment buttons in the paragraph group. What are these? Align text left, center, yes, align text right, and justify. Okay, you have to pronounce with me. Align text left, center, align text right, justify. These are four alignment buttons in the paragraph group button. Okay, so there is another button in the paragraph, that is align spacing. With the help of this button, you can also format your text. And when I say format, what it means? Yes, it means to make your text look beautiful. So line spacing means to give the space between one line and another line. Like there you can see in this area where I'm moving my pointer, here the line spacing or the gap between two lines is more as compared to the line space or the line gap between these two, right? there is less gap between them and there is more gap or space between them. So even you can change the line spacing with the help of this button, that is align spacing. Okay, when you click on this drop down arrow, different options will appear and you can select any one of your choice. At the end, and this one, start a list. As you can see, these are the bullet points I have given. This it's like a start a list. Start a list means to give bullet points to your text. Like this is a line written normally, but in this area you can see these small dots or circles. So that is from where you are going to put these dots or circles. From start a list, you are going to press on this drop down arrow, and there you can find so many options, like there must be tick or any other shapes you want to put. So all of these buttons are in the paragraph group. Okay, now let's revise the names again. Align text left, center, and remember you have to memorize the shape or the icon of the button. Like this means center, there's a line and then second line in the middle, which is a bit shorter than the first line. Okay, and align text right. As you can see, all of the text is being arranged, like lines are being arranged on the right side like this. And justify means both sides are equals. You can see here, or it's justify. Then line spacing, you can see arrow upward and downward arrow, and there are lines over here. Okay, and start a list as bullet points are already shown in this button. So these are the names of some paragraph group buttons. Memorize them, okay, and also memorize the icon of these buttons. Now it's time for practice. It's time for you to do practical activity. So just start WordPad, same process, same method. Click on the start menu right here, WordPad, like this. Okay, this is how you're gonna open WordPad. So today we are going to open already saved document, the practical which we had done in our previous lecture. That was about this one. I saved that practical with the name of computer exercise 1, page 38. So that is the recent document. What is it? Recent document. So I'm going to open from here. Not I'm going to use this process like open and then window will appear. Here I can see recent document. So today I'm going to open from here. Okay, so this was our previous practical that we have done in our previous lecture. Like we apply formatting by changing the color, highlighting, increasing the size, and changing the size or font family by changing the style of the fonts. Okay, so today we are going to apply some more formatting. Like we will start with, we will first of all make the names bold. As we in the previous topic or previous practical activity, we made them highlight the names of the person. Now today we're gonna make them bold. Just have to select, remember first point select, then go into the bold, make it darker like this. Now it looks dark. Now again, Sam is also named, select the surname and click on bold. Anne is also the name of a person, select it and go into the font group, click bold. Now you can see the names are bold. Okay, they are getting bold, like thicker or darker. Again, Pam, select the name and click on B, that is bold. So what you have to do, you have to bold the names like this. Okay, so now the second thing is that you have to make the text italics. I want to make all of the text italics like this. Select all of the text like this and click italics. Now you can see they are the text is a bit slanting, like sideways. This is how you are going to do this, okay? Just select the text and press italics. I is for italic. Okay, now here you can see Max loves apple. Apple starts with A. Now I'm gonna underline all of the letters like A, B, C and D. First select A and click underline, okay, like this. Again select A and underline it. You have to do same for all of the letters A, B, C and D. Underline it. Now again only select this part and again go into the font group, underline, select, underline. Where is the underline button? That is in the font group. Okay, underline button is in the font group. Select the day, select the letter D, underline it, and the last one is like this. So we make the text bold, italics and underline. This is how it looks like. Okay, now we will move on to the paragraph group button. So there are four different colors and I want first two lines to be on the left side. They are already on the left side, okay, like this. Now the second blue color, that is two lines of blue color. Sam loves ball. Ball starts with B. I'm gonna select these two lines and I want them in the center. Just select them and click center like this. Okay, this is how you are going to apply the alignment. Now this third color is of green. Okay, two lines select. I'm going to select them and I want them into the right side of the document. Just click on it. This is how they look like. Okay, they are on the right side of the screen document. As you can see, left side is this one, center, right side, and the last one is purple, and we will make it like justify it, or you can even make it center because it looks even like this. Okay, this is how you're going to select, choose or make the formatting, apply formatting alignment. Okay, this is how it looks. And the final is about, you are going to give a line spacing. Okay, change the line spacings. You have, for this you have to select all of the text like this, and what you're gonna do, you are going to go into the line spacing button. That is a drop down arrow here, you can see. Okay, so when you click on it, here you can see other options like 1.0, 1.15, 1.5 or 2. Okay, so right now it's in the 1.15. now if you click on other options, like if you want to less gap between two lines, then you can click on 1.0 like this. As you can see, they move upward and there is bit much gap between them, but I want more gap, so I'm going to choose 1.5. so now here you can see how it looks like. Okay, so there is more gap between one and the other line, between two lines, you can see over here. Okay, now I don't like this green color on the right side of the screen. I'm going to make it back on the left side. Okay, this is how it, now it's even. So this is our today's practical, like what we have done: make the text bold, italics, underline, and justify, or you can say align the text on the right side of the screen and then make it in the center. This is how you are going, and change, and even change the line spacing, the space or the gap between the lines. So you have to do this same process, like you have to select the names and make them bold, all of the text italics, and just letters underline them, and first and third like red and green color lines on the right side, on the left side of the screen, and blue and purple lines text in the center of them. Okay, so this is what you are going to do. Same things you have to apply them and practice. Hope all of you will practice. Now, before closing, one most important step is that you have to save it. Okay, by using, you can save from by going into the file group button and then click save. Or what is another option? That is click Control S. This is how you are going to save your document also. Okay, now I'm going to close it. So this was our practical activity. So now it's time for home task. You have to do same process, same methods, follow the same steps and do your activity. Like, you have to open already saved document, make the text bold, like names of a person, make it bold, all of the text italics, and just letters, underline them and apply the alignment. Okay, you can choose whatever alignment you want. If you want all of them in the center, you can do this, or some on the right side of or left side, you can even do that. Okay, so now it's time for preview. In our upcoming lecture, we are going to continue the same chapter, that is formatting in Wattpad, and we are going to attempt book exercises also that are on page number 41 and 42, that is exercise A, B and C. So it's time for you to ask questions. If you have any questions, you can ask in WhatsApp group. You are more than welcome. And thank you for listening. Take care of yourselves. Till then, Allah Hafiz, everyone.
بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. السلام علیکم گریڈ ٹو, کیسے ہیں آپ؟ میں آپ کی عربی کی ٹیچر مسز روبینہ اشرف. آپ سب بچے کیسے ہیں؟ ٹھیک ہے. اور سنائیں, سب خوب پڑھائی پہ دھیان دے رہے ہیں؟ چلیں بچوں, آج آپ کا عربک کا لیکچر ہے, اور آج ہمارا بچوں لیکچر ہے نمبر 8. لیکچر نمبر 8 یعنی کہ لیکچر نمبر 8 ہے. آپ اپنی عربک بکلیٹ پیج نمبر 15 یعنی کہ پیج صفحہ نمبر 15 اوپن کر لیں. ٹھیک ہے. تو بچوں آج ہم کیا پڑھیں گے, ہم بتاتے ہیں آپ کو. جی بچوں, آج ہم رنگوں کے نام لکھیں گے اور ان کو یاد کریں گے اور پھر ان میں رنگ بھریں گے انشاءاللہ. تو چلیں بچوں ہم اپنے لیکچر کی طرف چلتے ہیں. جی بچوں, یہ کلرز کے نیم ہیں, رنگوں کے نام ہیں. ہم آپ کو عربک میں رنگوں کے نام بتائیں گے اور اس کے بعد اردو میں اس کا ترجمہ بتائیں گے. تو یہ بچوں 6-7 رنگوں کے نام آپ کو نظر آ رہے ہیں, وہ اب ہم پہلے اس کی پڑھائی کرتے ہیں اور پھر میں آپ کو ایکسپلین کروں گی. سب سے پہلا رنگ کا نام ہے بچوں عربی میں احمر. احمر سرخ, احمر ریڈ سرخ. پہلا کلر کا نام کیا ہے بچوں؟ احمر. احمر میں اردو, احمر عربی میں سرخ کو کہتے ہیں, ریڈ کو کہتے ہیں. ٹھیک ہے بچوں. دوسرا کلر نیم ہے ازرق. ازرق, ازرق نیلا, ازرق نیلا. احمر سرخ, ازرق نیلا. احمر سرخ, ازرق نیلا. تیسرا نام ہے بچوں اصفر. اصفر, اصفر پیلا, اصفر پیلا, اصفر پیلا. جی بچوں, چوتھا رنگ کا نام کیا ہے؟ اخضر. اخضر, اخضر بھی کہتے ہیں بچوں سے اور اخضر بھی کہتے ہیں. ٹھیک ہے. اخضر سبز ہرا, اخضر سبز ہرا. اور بچوں آگے ہے ارجوانی. ارجوانی جامنی, ارجوانی جامنی, ارجوانی جامنی. جی بچوں, ابھی تک ہم نے کون سے رنگ پڑھے ہیں؟ احمر سرخ, ازرق نیلا, اصفر پیلا, اخضر ہرا, ارجوانی جامنی, جامنی پرپل. ٹھیک ہے بچوں. جی آگے چلتے ہیں بچوں, آگے کون سا رنگ کا نام ہے؟ ابیض. ابیض سفید, ابیض سفید, ابیض سفید. جی بچوں, اور لاسٹ میں کیا نام نظر آ رہا ہے ہمیں؟ اسود. اسود کالا, اسود کالا, اسود کالا. آپ کو پتا ہے نا بچوں, مکہ مکرمہ میں حجر اسود ہے, وہ کالے رنگ کا ہے نا, تو اسود کا مطلب کیا ہے؟ کالا, اسود کالا. جی بچوں, یہ عربی میں ہم نے رنگوں کے نام پڑھے ہیں. میں ایک دفعہ پھر اس کی دہرائی کر دیتی ہوں بچوں, تاکہ آپ کو اچھی طرح یہ ذہن نشین ہو جائیں. ٹھیک ہے. تو چلیں میں ریپیٹ کر رہی ہوں, آپ نے بھی میرے ساتھ پڑھنا ہے. احمر سرخ, احمر سرخ, ازرق نیلا, ازرق نیلا, اصفر پیلا, اصفر پیلا, اخضر ہرا, اخضر ہرا, ارجوانی جامنی, ارجوانی جامنی, ابیض سفید, ابیض سفید, اسود کالا, اسود کالا, احمر سرخ یعنی کہ ریڈ. ٹھیک ہے. ازرق نیلا بلو, بلو کلر بچوں. اصفر پیلا یلو, یلو کلر کو کہتے ہیں اصفر. ٹھیک ہے. اخضر ہرا مینس گرین کلر. ارجوانی جامنی means purple color. Habiyat, sufed, white color. Aswad, kala, black color. ठीक है बच्चों, आपको रंगों के नाम का पता चल गया ना कि अरबी में क्या कहते हैं और उसको उर्दू में क्या कहते हैं, और इंग्लिश में तो आपको पता ही है. ठीक है, अब हम आगे चलते हैं. जी बच्चों, रंगों के नाम हमने पढ़ने हैं और वही कलर हमने आगे वाले भरने हैं. ठीक है, आपने अपनी बुकलेट पर इसको भरना है. अहमर सुर्ख रंग भरेंगे आप. ठीक है, अहमर सुर्ख, तो अहमर के आगे आपने सुर्ख कलर भरना है और लिखना भी है. ठीक है, दूसरा है बच्चों अजरक. अजरक आप नीला रंग भरेंगे इसमें. ठीक है, नीला ब्लू. अहमर सुर्ख, सुर्ख मतलब रेड, रेड कलर आपने भरना है. नंबर टू पर है बच्चों अजरक. अजरक नीला मींस ब्लू कलर आपने यहां भरना है. ठीक है, उसके बाद बच्चों असफर. असफर पीला, पीला येलो कलर आपने भरना है. ठीक है बच्चों, असफर पीला, पीला येलो कलर. जी उसके बाद है बच्चों अक्सर. अक्सर सब्स हरा, ग्रीन कलर बच्चों आपने सामने भरना है. जी बच्चों आगे अर्जवानी. पर जामनी पर्पल कलर बच्चों आपने, ये देखें कलर्स हमने उसी तरह लिखे हैं, वही कलर देख के आपने भरने हैं. अर्जवानी जामनी कलर आपने भरना है. अबियत सफेद, सफेद कलर आपने अबियत के सामने, उसे वाइट ही रहने देना है. ठीक है, और अस्वद, अस्वद में आपने ब्लैक कलर भरना है. ठीक है, समझ में आ गया बच्चों आपको? बहुत इजी है कलर्स नेम याद करना. एक दफा मैं फिर आपके लिए इसे रिपीट कर देती हूँ ताकि आप इसे अच्छी तरह जहन नशी कर लें. ठीक है बच्चों, अहमर सुर्ख रेड, अजरक नीला ब्लू, असफर पीला येलो, अक्सर हरा सब्ज, अर्जवानी जामनी पर्पल, अबियत सफेद व्हाइट, अस्वद काला मींस ब्लैक. ठीक है बच्चों, मुझे उम्मीद है कि आपने बहुत अच्छी तरह गौर से देखा होगा और याद किया होगा इसको. समझ में आ गया ना बच्चों? इसे अच्छी तरह आपने याद भी करना है. जी बच्चों, तो बच्चों अब आपको घर का काम दे दिया जाए. तो बच्चों आप अरबी बुकलेट में सफा नंबर 15 पर कलर्स के नाम आपने लिखने हैं और याद करने हैं. ये आपके घर का काम है. और अगर आपको कोई चीज समझ नहीं आती तो आप व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप पर अपनी अरेबिक की टीचर से पूछ सकते हैं. ठीक है बच्चों, आज का हमारा लेक्चर खत्म हो गया है बच्चों. अपना बहुत ख्याल रखिएगा. ठीक है, ओके बच्चों, अल्लाह हाफिज़.